Welcome to game number 7, UC Davis, NCAA 14 Revamped Dynasty. As we see here, we got a game coming up against Utah State. Once again, unsurprisingly, team has better ratings overall in all three phases of the game, an overall rating. So, coming off a big loss last week, Sac State, I definitely think I treated that a little bit of a easy game when I shouldn't have. Try not to make those same mistakes this week. Yeah, teams look pretty middling here as well. But again, we made that mistake last week with Sac State, paid for it with a loss. So this week, going to definitely try and play a little bit smarter, play a little bit more disciplined, and let's see how it turns out.
Hi everybody, Reese Davis with you, bringing you the EA
Should be an interesting game. It's a conference game,
football
so we really can't afford to lose any more of these going forward.
Nissan. Innovation that
Utah State
excites.
Has some really cool jerseys. I like
the
those.
The Mountain West has been adept at producing.
Not sure if they're the most updated version
from the so-called
what they have currently, but
a
these are pretty
level
cool jerseys.
Of football being played in the Mountain West. We expect a great matchup
today.
High
level.
Thanks for checking out the pregame show. NCAA college football action coming up next with Brad and Kirk on the call. David and I will see you at halftime.
I do think, though, going from this season to next season is going to be a big, big jump in performance.
And
because
the coin toss, and it's brought to you
we
by
have
Coke
too many
Zero.
Players in the 50s and 60s starting right now. I don't know if there's
calories.
Any, maybe
enjoy everything.
Maybe a handful that are in the 70s that are starting currently, but yeah, we're going to definitely have some changes going up, coming up in the depth chart next season. But for now, just trying to do the best we can, and you know, if we can secure a bowl game, I think that would be a successful
first year.
Both
teams are on the field, and we're just about ready to open things up.
Love for Garrett to get some going in the return game as well.
He's to the 20. Brought down at the 29-yard line.
Yeah.
Have shown over the course
Great.
Of the season that they want to get this guy the football, but you can't just go to him every play.
Well, on the road, you're
well, we try to
take the crowd out of the game, and the one guy
the best player
you know who can do it
all
is this wide receiver. The problem you have is this
so,
defense
start
more
with
often
the,
than not is
going
to be aligned to take him out of the game. And that, to your point,
right
Brad, that's where somebody's going to have to step up, whether it's the running game or some of the other receivers. Have to take some of the pressure off.
Why did they do that little spin move at the end?
To be able to win this game
they do a complete turnaround. He slowed us down.
To the running back.
This young man is becoming more and more part of this passing game. He does a great job of making guys miss after the catch.
First and 10. Ball on their own 40.
I think that Cannon is the only player on pace for 1,000 yards at anything, whether receiving or running. Garrett just is inconsistent. It's not Garrett. It's a lot of the offensive line. We really are hit.
Come out a bit more motivated next
First
time.
Contact is usually either right behind the line or right at the line of scrimmage, so it's very difficult for us to get anything going with the run game. Let's see if a toss play will work. C73 can get out and actually make a block. Well, it's Silveria, so. What is going on here?
And they got him for a loss.
That's a great
Where are the offensive linemen going?
There's nothing like a defense being able to slip off of a block, get into the backfield of the offense, and then make a play in the backfield.
It's a pretty bad play calling as well. Like
momentum possibly for this defense.
We need something a little bit deeper here.
Third and 12. Ball on their own 38. Under pressure, he sails it long. Doesn't get
Come on, go for the
Wright's
ball.
The kind of guy that could end up with some national honors because right now he's leading the conference statistically.
Yeah, but we are. There is not a big gap between our touchdowns and interceptions this season.
Wright is the putter. The ball changes hands on the punt. Nice opening stand by the
I really like the colors of
sure the
Utah State.
I'm thrilled to see their guys come up with an early stop in this game. Let's see if the offense can give them something else to get excited about now.
If I remember this now, it's so I can focus on the quarterback. So we always, it always just screws us.
The quarterback brings his troops out of the field for the first drive
way.
Of the game.
After they bust a big run to the QB. So this time I remember, so that's good.
Makes it to the 22-yard line.
Dimino's been balling. This guy should definitely be in contention for the Bernard.
From their own 22-yard line. Second down.
He's got sacks. He's got tackles for losses. I think he's got a pick. You know, he's leading the team in tackles. Oh, he looked better than
that. Fires quickly, and he's got his man. Tackles him at 28.
That was the first time I've been doubled as a defensive end. All right, let's see what happens here. A little bit of press. Predicting a pass.
This quarterback needs to give his playmakers a chance to make plays. He's got to be
sure
he gets the ball in their hands.
I also, this punt return left, right thing, Garrett, I mean, is there a part of the field where it's better to do one or the other?
Garrett fields it at the 37. He's tackled at the 43-yard line.
That didn't even feel like a 7-yard run. I felt like I got like a yard there. All right, let's see if we can get something going.
Every drive's important in a tie game. I look for both sides to come out with some urgency.
All right, Cannon. Good job.
They picked up quite a few yards on that play, Kirk.
Well, that was an excellent route, and he did a great job of holding on to the football.
From the
40, I don't want to abandon the running game too early, so I'm going to keep trying to run it. All right. That's some positive.
And he makes it out to about the 37-yard line.
Two rushes, 2 yards. Ridiculous. Let's try see what play action is like against this type of team.
Right, sets up the play action. Loose football.
And that's what I was worried about. Play action with this crappy ass offensive line.
So far, it's been
usually I learn my lesson, get sacked or something.
Like
this is ridiculous.
Every possession is likely to matter. Quick throw out to the receiver.
Come on,
he gets hit out of bounds around the 11-yard line. Now it's first and 10 with the defense trying to regroup after giving
I commit to the run
pass.
There. Doesn't seem like he's gonna run. But it's kind of crazy. Can't get any movement on the defense line. Damn, what a terrible start against this game. Turnovers, man.
He makes the PAT. A short turnovers,
not good.
Come away with a touchdown. Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. Garrett from the one. Looking for the corner. He makes it to maybe the 20-yard line.
I really don't see a reason
and while they are behind,
to run up the middle on the return.
It's way too early to change your game plan.
Look at that. Just gets out the block like it's nothing. I did invest a lot of recruitment into the offensive line this season. Hopefully we can start locking some of those guys down because this is just horrendous.
Here's the tight end. Has a first down.
And our receivers have no speed. Also, there's just no separation. That's why I've thrown so many picks, because I'm trying to anticipate the location.
Quick pass.
Okay.
He's to the 40. And they make the stop around the 42-yard line.
I don't know why Silveria is coming in so much, though. I'm gonna have to check the distribution, the substitution slider.
From their own 42-yard line, first down. Quickly incomplete.
Oh my God, their hands are just non-existent on this team.
Was left out to dry that time.
Was he though? Because he looked wide open. Oh, thank God he held on to that.
They like to run through all their routes before the game. And I have to say, they look sharp before this one even started.
From the 47.
That was good. He made some catches. That was a tough catch. Oh my God. Face mask. Man, not a good first quarter.
That's going to do it for the first quarter. We got
starting to move the ball down the field. We didn't have too many issues. I think we got 3 or 4 first downs. It's just that the turnover, the first drive ended with a terrible,
I think we were like third and 14. Here in the second quarter.
And then the second drive ended with a fumble. So, longest run of the game. I wish there was more of that effect in this game, though, where if you're running the ball, running the ball, running the ball, the defense line starts to get tired on the other team. I don't know how much that is actually in play, though. I'm sure there's probably some mechanics for it, but... Comeback route with Cannon is working, so
it's a risky throw here by the
that was tight.
Cannot keep tossing it
risky.
Up into the secondary like that, and
but everybody else
guy
is
to come down
covered.
With it every time. The defense is going to jump on one of those and take it the other way.
It's the ninth play of the drive. Nice run there.
Okay.
Garrett gets 6 yards on the carry.
All right, at least he's leveraging more than 1 yard the last
second
few times.
Down, they're going to need about 3 yards to pick up the first down.
Okay, let's see. A read option here. How did they know that freaking offensive lineman was in? That defensive lineman was in.
He keeps it on the option and picks up maybe 4.
Maybe 3. Oh, on the fumble, I guess they didn't count it as a sack. They counted it as a run. Get to that hole, buddy!
Well, that's the second time that this defense has given up a first down on third down.
All right. So moving the ball down the field.
To get an offense to third down, when you get them there, you've got to be able to
11
have
plays.
Somebody step up and make a big play, whether it's a defensive tackle slipping through a block, a linebacker shooting a gap, a defender in the secondary that's able to make a play on a football. Somebody
that was
make
a touchdown.
Play. And that's what winning, the difference between winning a football game and losing is how you play on third down.
That was a touchdown.
From the 18-yard line, second down. Now he tries to buy some time. Great pressure on the quarterback.
That was, what the hell was that? That was a rollout
really
smash?
Him on that throw.
The only thing that got, I rolled out and I got smashed.
And here's the 14th play of the drive.
I'm running a deep curl here. If Slope gets open, I'm going there. King hold on the ball. Run him over. Run him over. There you go. There you go. Put that shoulder down. Lower that shoulder. I mean, look at this. This is nice.
And did that play ever develop nicely?
Here we go.
It's all about the receiver on this play.
Catching him.
Man off the line and then ran a perfect route.
Him
all he had to do
down.
Make the catch.
Wow, nice play.
Here comes the kicker to
touchdown,
try to tie this
board.
Game up.
14 play drive, wow.
He splits the uprights with the extra point. White gets set to kick this one away.
Now we need our defense to play. Well, defense.
Gentry. Stanford from the four. And down he goes at the 26.
Get him. Again, I don't see any reason to run the ball on a return.
They've been like a couple of fighters feeling each other out so far. Let's see if they start to.
Maybe Barron, we can actually get off a friggin' block so we can get some sacks and maybe make the quarterback hurry his throws. That'd be great as well, wouldn't it?
Where's it out to the right to the halfback? Tackle made.
Okay,
about the 33-yard line.
You can't be missing those tackles.
They need about 3 yards to get the first here on second down. They'll spread the field with five wide.
Oh, no, get back. Oh, I wasn't on the line.
Pass incomplete, trying to get it to his receiver.
Oh, what are you doing, Lewis?
That makes it third and three.
Lewis, that was a pick. Oh, my God, I cannot believe that literally was straight to him.
Throws on the run. Brought down.
How is he wide open like that?
From the 39-yard line. First down. Slings it.
You know, it's funny, I played a more shallow coverage right where somebody should have been. Where the hell was Griggs there? These guys are getting toasted, literally. It's kind of, not literally, I mean, figuratively, but still, nonetheless, it's kind of ridiculous. The only incompletion, I think, was a throwaway.
Inside the 10, and he's taken down at the 4.
Oh, and I was Casper right up front. And instead of hitting the quarterback, I went.
Pass play with this defense.
I chased the pass. Oh, freaking ran it for once.
The 3 yard line. So he gets maybe a yard on the option. Utah State will take a timeout. That's their first of the half. They're at the 3. Second down.
This dude really loves to. This might be a play action. They love throwing the ball. We gotta bring some pressure here.
Gets it quickly to the tight end, but it's dropped.
Oh, thank God. That was big.
This isn't much more than an extra point.
And we're gonna have some time to score. I think we, I already forgot whether we I think we started the game.
Sometimes
the ball.
What happens on a false start is a lineman will see movement on the other Dolphin. Side of the ball and be coaxed into jumping early.
Utah State could take the lead with this field goal. It's up.
I don't even know what I'm trying.
Even though they gave up a field goal here, that defense is feeling pretty good about themselves right now. It could have just as easily been a touchdown.
It was very bend don't break type defensive drive there.
He sends this one deep. They bring him down, and they bring him down hard on that one. Both offenses have played it pretty close to the fence so far.
Because they've been so conservative, it's made it pretty easy for both of these defenses to be pretty dominant. Let's see an offense open it up and take a few chances.
There hasn't been too much daylight between these two teams. In games like this, some players try to press too much, and that can cause mistakes. He's brought down in the open field. That's a
team of 17. Nobody's pressing. Moving the ball.
From their own 32-yard line, it's first down. Fires right side, got his tailback. He's at midfield.
I think a key in being able to throw.
That was a good game.
Is the quarterback selling it? looking downfield as if he's going to throw the ball downfield, knowing he's about to retreat and just dump it to his running back. So I think the quarterback is the key, being able to time it up, wait for that pressure to get to him, and then wait to the last possible second to deliver the football to the receiver or running back.
Quick throw out to the receiver, incomplete.
Oh my God, what the heck? That would have been dangerous.
Good effort by the defender.
Second down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 45. Caught with room to work.
Oh, yeah, he looked wide open.
He's tackled around the 23-yard line. So the Aggies will use their first time out of the half.
I'm not sure if the back was his first option, but he got in the ball, and he was able to make something big happen.
Incomplete. And that wasn't the greatest pass in the world.
Well, I don't know how anybody can throw a great pass while getting drilled like
that. We're taking completion there.
From the 23-yard line, it's second down. And that sets them up.
Yes! I saw them. I saw that receiver next to him, and I thought maybe it might work. Oh my God, that corner!
You know, as a running back, you've got to get upfield north and south. That time, he just seemed to wait and kind of delay his reaction, and just got to be able to make a read, get upfield as quickly as possible. College football, especially up in the NFL, the more you're dancing,
fire quickly, touchdown!
Yes, baby. Yes. Sent him out on a route there. That worked out way better than I anticipated. I thought there would be maybe some, he might be able to pull the defender away, but instead he got wide open.
And he adds the extra point. An 8-play, 85.
Well, Randy Wright's definitely off to a much better game. Hard to play a worse game than we played against Sac State, where he had 4 INTs, 0 touchdowns.
From the 5-yard line.
This game, we're spreading the ball around quite a bit. You know, the midfield logo is so big, it's deceptive.
Momentum swings have been fairly even. There was so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays.
Really?
Tackle around the 36-yard line. Utah State's going to have to use their second timeout.
Why? Is that programmed into the game where they make them run the first? Is there something to
it's
that?
Second down and they're about 2 yards
understand.
Away from the sticks. And they've got the dime package in there to try and deal with this 5-receiver look. And it's picked off.
Yes.
And he's tackled right around the 36-yard line.
Do we have time to run 36? If we run like a quick out. 30, 40 set. That's wait. Yeah, no, that's not right.
From the 36-yard line, first down. So we'll probably get one last heave to the end zone here before halftime.
Go out.
He's looking for 6. He goes up and gets it. It's a touchdown.
What a catch! What a catch! What a catch! I faced up and I really, the game like tweaked out for a second. Oh my God, he made the catch. What a play.
And he hits the PAT.
That was wild. I was thinking about Hail Mary, but my receiver was so damn slow.
The Tigers rolling.
What a freaking play at the buzzer.
Tight one to the very end. The Tigers top it off with a 7-point win.
Our score, 21-10. And that'll do it for the
man,
first half.
That was amazing. Great job, Garrett's having a freaking half. Not running the ball, but he's having a half. He's got almost 100 yards receiving.
Glad to have you with us in the studio for the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 halftime show presented by
Nissan.
Really
want to get the run game going, though. That's something I really want to do.
Reese Davis and David Pollock here completely locked in on that first half. Both pass offenses putting up
Randy Wright, three touchdowns in the first half.
Frankly, the two quarterbacks have been able to get very comfortable in the pocket. What can the defensive line do to change that in the second half?
Starters would be, hey, how about you hit the quarterback a few times? That would be a good place
nice.
To start.
That pick was
big.
Most
quarterbacks look really
look
good
at that
until
freaking
you hit them in the
catch.
Mouth a few times and you make them feel uncomfortable. And until you do that, it's
I was worried
like
that one of the defenders would come
on
around and get in front of him. He's not a big dude. He's like 5'8".
Well, put him in a green jersey right now, because all they're doing right now is just doing drive-bys and whiffing right by him and not touching the quarterback. Hit the guy.
David's ready to get back on that couch, get the remote, get all the games dialed up to watch what's going on around the country.
They got 6 yards, but I think they only ran one right play.
Brad and Kirk ready to roll.
Oh, that was big. That was so
Welcome back,
big.
Everybody. Second half action about to begin.
Because we are kicking off. Being down,
and he got
being
all
up, sorry.
This one. Great kick.
14-10 and 21-10. Big difference, obviously.
He's to the 20.
Good.
He's tackled at the 25-yard line.
Up.
There's got to be some sense of urgency to this offense right now.
So
they
NCAA
don't have the luxury of wasting drives if they want to get back
in the
game.
I guess it'll be called 23 or college football 23.
Gets it out to his receiver in a hurry. And
I
they
really
make the stop around the 35-yard line.
They don't change it too much. I personally would be happy with the exact game as is, reskinned with all the updated jerseys and uniforms and the graphics.
From their own,
you know, that's
35
not
going to
happen. I guess they're doing it on Frostbite, which I guess is the same game as Madden. So that actually might be a reason why I have to buy Madden so I can get used to the controls in that game.
Pass complete and taken down immediately.
This guy's freaking release is ridiculous.
That brings him second and five.
Play some press coverage. Force him to run the ball a little bit longer. I'm not even going to get to the quarterback.
Right, running back's got it. They'll bring him down around the 44-yard line.
What a heady move by this receiver. He ran his route, didn't get the football at first, saw that his quarterback was still alive.
Look at 36. Slow ass.
Result,
started the middle and had time to run over there.
First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 44-yard line. It's the tailback. Makes it out to about the 36.
They're running the ball. What the hell? How many rushes does this guy have? Five? Okay. I don't know when he had five rushes, but sure.
It looks like they're going to blitz. They bring him down in the backfield. So they wrapped
yes.
him up before he could get anything going.
Yeah, there was nothing there on that option.
Nothing.
Third down, and they're going to need about 3 yards to pick up the first down.
Okay, let's see what happens here. Frick.
And he just gets rid of it.
Get up, Aaron. Good coverage by the D there. While Barron was laying on the floor, I was looking around and people were covered. So that was okay. All right. They're gonna go for it.
Fourth down, and the offense is still on the field.
Switch.
Strike to his receiver. No good. The defense.
Oh, got the hit on the quarterback. There it is. Put some pressure on him finally.
This offense has really seemingly been unstoppable. Should be interesting to see now if the defense has changed things up as they try to stop these guys. Nice gain as he works the right side.
Oh my God. That is a lot of work for 4 yards.
Second down and six. Ball on their own 42. hits him hard at midfield.
Okay. Okay, 100 yards right on the dot. Two touchdowns receiving. Oh, yeah, that's right. I remember.
And he's tackled after positive yardage.
Yes. Finally moving the ball on the ground.
So it's second down now, and they need about 4 yards to pick up the first.
Total 200 total yards.
Quick pass, intercepted.
That was forced. Unnecessary. Unnecessary. You know, it's kind of interesting though, because it almost seems like the teams I'm playing against, at least, they do not drop the ball on picks.
Got the corner. He gets hit out of bounds.
Where are we going, Seth?
44-yard line. The pass results in a first down.
I'll tell you. Great call by the coach.
I should just stop pretending these guys are going to run the ball. I don't know why I am.
When they're expecting the run, and then they end up with another first
down. Overly
concerning
myself with this, with anything but a pass play defense.
Ball in the 44. Gains his way to the 33-yard line.
Woo! Lay the hammer, Griggs. Keeping my dime defense on.
From the 30-yard line,
I think it's gonna be good.
Second down. Zips it to the back.
Get back, get to the freaking side of the screen. Yes. There you go.
So the Aggies taking their first time out of the half.
I'm gonna call timeout to get my defense refreshed a bit. I'm gonna do a quarter because you know these stupid running backs.
From the 27-yard line, it's third down. Catches it, and that's all. Williams picks up about 4
yes.
yards with a catch.
They're gonna go for it. They gotta go for it here, right? They went for it when they were goal. Okay, just in case they run it.
And it looks like they might be bringing some pressure here. Wide open, and he just drops it.
Yes! Okay, we get one turned around here.
The offense comes out to start this drive, and they're hoping for a better result as they threw a pick on their last possession.
And we'll see how aggressive this defense is when they come back out. I wouldn't be surprised if they kept up the pressure to try to fluster this quarterback some more.
And down he goes, right around.
Look at that defensive lineman, man. Chasing him down.
So at the end of the
anybody know if the slide protection stuff matters when in the running game?
Welcome
I'm curious.
Back to the action here as we resume play here in quarter number 4. They keep it on the ground with a tailback. Runs it left for a decent game.
Okay, got the first down. I'm trying some no huddle running here. See if that makes a difference. Seems like really honestly you can't get around the edge, can't do anything, so. What are you doing? Come on.
And he's taken down at the 36-yard line.
This is crazy.
from their own 36-yard line. Second down.
Having your first.
Big opening. And he is drilled at the 44-yard
yes.
line.
Yes.
That makes it first and 10.
Trying different runs, off tackle, between the tackles.
Sweet. Up the middle for a nice game.
Okay, that guy, oh boy! Try to hurdle that dude on the ground and ended up. 13 rushes, 42 yards.
They need about 3 yards to get the first here on second down. Fires across the middle. He's taken down at the 30-yard line.
Hemmingson is clutch. This guy's got the best hands on the team, I think. Trying to catch them off balance a little bit. Some short passes while they're they're committed to runs.
Brought down around the
Severia. All right. Oh, okay. He's still up. It is good for
this is the eighth play of this drive.
All right, I'm going to get this play call. It's a pass play.
Now he tries to buy some time. Throws on the move and it's intercepted. And that's a second interception.
Oh my God, I regretted it.
These guys are all over the field. It seems like wherever the quarterback throws the ball, there's a defender sitting right there.
It's first down. Tough spot here, deep in their own territory.
Again, I think it's kind of wild that they don't drop interceptions. It could be a linebacker or whatever it is. They're not dropping picks.
Complete. He's got room. He's tackled right around the 22-yard line.
Well, if this defense keeps taking chances with these blitzes, sure, they may get to the quarterback once in a while, but they also are giving up some big plays like that one right there.
Jones lay in the wood
from their own 22-yard line. Second down.
I don't think Barron's got a sack in like this would be second straight game, I think.
And it's the senior.
What's that?
Tackle around the 38-yard line.
Oh, come on. That kind of crap should not be happening. Should not be able to make catches like that.
And a nice catch there before he stepped out of bounds.
Not positive he made that catch, but I'm not going to challenge
it. Less than 3 minutes in the game.
Drops an interception. What's ironic about that?
Sales catch that pick.
Is that this guy's been telling the coaches he wants to play some wide receiver? You wonder why you're not playing wide receiver? Because you can't catch.
No. What's ironic is how my guys won't make interceptions on every single pass that comes to them, and computer will.
Great concentration to haul it in. Penalty marker down in the backfield might be a hole.
Come on, man. He's right in front of you, dude. And.
So the offense will move a little bit closer.
I think this penalty is a little exaggerated in this game. Because if your guy's midair, I'm going to call timeout.
And this play is number 8 on the drive.
That was on soft thing.
I think the defense jumped the gun a little bit on that play.
Oh, I was offsides. Okay.
He goes. goes over 100 yards in reception.
Well, this guy is such a big part of this offense. If he doesn't get his numbers, they usually don't have much success moving the football.
First and goal from the 3. They're knocking on the door. And he's tackled around the 1 yard line. The back gets 3 on the carry.
That brings up second and goal.
This is the 10th play of this drive.
It's kind of funny, but I'm running
just over 2 minutes in the game.
Dying. The goal line.
Makes a move and he's in for the touchdown. So the offense
will
go for 2.
That brought the team back to life a bit.
And it looks like they're going to bring some heat.
Man, this guy freaking wins the ball game.
They got it.
All right, we can't screw up this drive.
He'll return it from the 1. And he's taken down to the 20-yard line. The quarterback couldn't maintain possession on their last drive. Let's see what he does here.
The first rule on offense is to take care of the football. These guys need to remember that on this drive.
He takes it right side for a good game. Garrett gets 6 yards on the carry. Utah State will take a timeout. That's their first of the half. 2 minutes left in the ball game.
First down.
Takes it left side, and he's brought down to the backfield. That was well defended by this defense.
The offensive line is so concerned with their penetrating abilities that these linebackers are able to roam free and make
until
plays like that.
Until our freaking... until our freaking run game.
Fires quick out to the receiver and he can't make the grab.
That is textbook pass defense. As soon as the ball hit the receiver's hands, he was all over it.
Less than 2 minutes in the fourth quarter. Gets it away. It's low. Utah State still got a chance here. They might come up short, but not for lack of trying.
Well, I've been impressed with this team the entire way. Now we're going to really find out what they're
goodness
made
gracious,
the
86 yards,
line,
second
late
half.
In the ball game, how do you go out and execute?
Both teams realize that when the ball is snapped, we're one play away from a very different ball game. He makes it to the 42-yard line.
Who was that? Casper?
Spikes the ball.
The AI
really
is seriously
third and long here in the
absurd.
Fourth quarter.
They run the ball and they spike it. They lost 2 downs basically.
Tackle after a decent run up the gun.
What in the hell are they? That wasn't a first. Okay, that was definitely not a first.
On the handoff, big hit, and he'll lose yardage. They couldn't get back to the line.
Yes, Barron, making a play. Why are they running the ball all of a sudden? Do they realize that they're losing?
Right in there and make a nice.
I had to double check the scoreboard here. Like, am I missing something?
It's second down. Halfback's got it on a quick throw. And he tackles.
Make contact with
the
freaking running back. Somebody tackle him. Come on.
He's going to air it long. Finds his receiver who's all alone.
We kind of deserve that. Because we got a little greedy trying to spread the ball around a little too much.
A six play, 60-yard drive, and a touchdown as a result.
Brad, I thought that was a textbook try.
That's crazy. That's crazy.
Mixing the play calling with the run and the pass, just an overall well-executed touchdown drive.
He's to the 10. He's to the 20. He's tackled at the 23.
Damn, he made a nice block there. Okay, and those timeouts,
well,
that
sets up the drama here in the fourth quarter. They've got the opportunity they've been looking for, an opportunity to take the lead and the win.
He steps out
around the 28-yard line.
Why are you so goddamn close to the freaking sideline?
From their own,
what kind of play call
line
is this?
Second down. The defender had it and then dropped it.
It can be tough making a play on the ball sometimes.
Oh, thank God.
That's probably a pick he should have made.
My team is trash.
Fires out to his wide out, and they make the stop around the 47-yard line.
Hemmingson, you clutch son of a gun. You clutch son of a gun.
They go back to him on a quick throw. He's out of bounds at the 22-yard line.
Oh, maybe I could have ran it. Oh, man.
First and 10. Ball on the 22. Looks to the back and can't connect.
These guys, especially in the secondary, really get after it and can make life.
I almost called a timeout on accident.
On the other side of the ball.
Picked off, and that'll seal it up. And that is an absolutely huge turnover for this defense. They couldn't have picked that off at a better time.
Just a horrible decision by the quarterback trying to force that pass, especially at this point in the game.
Oh,
and this
my
should
God
be a kneel down as they just try to kill the clock. They'll go down.
What
on
a
knee.
Freaking turnaround.
Garrett's big performance.
My team is honestly just trash. Bad decisions by me, I'm not gonna lie.
Day for his team. You know, he had a great but, individual performance, but you know, you think about the team first, obviously, if you're this star player, and he cannot be happy with, even though he had a great game. This
that is very, very, very disappointing.
Game of NCAA football 14. And everyone here at
frankly, a bit depressing that I did what we just did, what I just did here. Losing that game, we had total control. That bomb at the end was ridiculous, though. They literally lost three plays, and then, you know what? We're just going to chuck it up and blew past our guy. But I understand this also. How the hell is the computer picking off almost every goddamn throw that goes their way? That was still a great play. Man, that top, that first half, you did not think this was going to go this the way it did. But look at that. That's absurd. Man, cannot wait for that recruiting class to get here. I am just stunned. And then the icing on that cake was that interception. Randy Wright is just having a terrible season. I think you're looking at like maybe 13 touchdowns, 14 touchdowns to 12 to 13 interceptions. But anyways, that's that. Another disappointing game, two in a row. I don't know, maybe there's something with recording in the evenings that isn't the best idea. But you know what? We're gonna suck it up and we're gonna get ready for next week. And with that being said, again, thank you guys for joining me. Those of you that watch, those of you who stay to the end, those of you who watch the whole video. You never know with this team. We could be up, we could be down, but it seems like almost every single game is ending on the possession or second to last possession here. So again, thank you guys, and I hope to see you guys next week.